My name is Molly Pitts.
I work for the Colorado Timber Industry Association, which is a statewide industry group that promotes logging and forest restoration type work. Behind me, you can see lots of dead trees. The epidemic really got started in the southern part of Colorado around probably 2002. One of the things that the spruce beetle epidemic has proven is that it crosses all boundaries. Doesn't care if it's national forest, private lands, doesn't care if it's timberland or recreational land. When you have an epidemic as large as our spruce beetle epidemic here in Colorado, we need to do some management for potential fire breaks in future, for habitat, and also for our recreational use.
My name is Clay Spees. I am a renewable resource staff officer in the GMG National Forest in Delta, Colorado. The spruce beetle project started back in 2013. And we had extensive mortality going on with our spruce across the national forest. Today, we have about 328,000 acres that have been affected by spruce beetle in this forest alone. The Forest Service plays a role that we are a partner with people like Montrose Forest Products. They harvest trees off the national forest for a variety of wood products that are utilized by American people.
So up here we have a harvesting operation that includes a feller buncher, which is what is used to cut the trees. And then you typically have a skidder that'll grab a bunch of trees and haul them into a landing. And there you have a processor, which will usually delimb them and cut them to length. Then they're ready to be loaded onto a log truck and hauled to the mill. I would say initially there was a lot of pushback on the idea of coming in and doing a lot of salvage. It was a new concept. We've always done salvaging on the small level, because we always have dead and dying trees in the forest. But this was big. This was gonna be landscape level. We hadn't thought that large before. I would say our typical environmentalists are more anti-management, but I consider myself somebody who wants to do right by the earth. I went to forestry school because I care about our forests.
Yard at Montrose Forest Products in Montrose, Colorado. This is one of the larger mills in this area. So what we wanted to do is to bring diverse stakeholders together to talk about how to manage, both in terms of public safety, but also to provide a product for local industry in a very environmentally sensitive manner. You do have everything from the timber industry would like to harvest trees to maintain the product, to keep mills open. You also have the conservation community that's more interested in terms of preservation, those types of perspectives. And so collaboration means you bring all those different interests together and you work together to reach a common goal. Local community really supports the timberland industry.
The salvaging around here directly provides jobs to some of our rural communities, which is really important. And it also becomes a marketable product that people buy each and every day.
The role of the industry to help us achieve our objective is very, very critical. We could not be doing what we're doing on this forest, for example, without Montrose Forest Products, as well as a variety of small purchasers we work with every day on the National Forest.
So as I look to the future for the next 10, 15, 20 years, the spruce beetle will have come and gone, primarily because they've run out of food. But we'll also see a lot of the younger, smaller trees, since they're released, getting more nutrients and sunlight. We're hoping that as we get more and more data, that trend will continue, that we'll continue to see the evidence that we're doing a really good job of protecting our next forest.